Well, I'm a bit of a coffee drinker, Sasha. Yeah.
Yes, that you are.
Some of you might be able to relate. I always have a cup of coffee in front of me. In my office, I have a coffee maker where I just make pot after pot.
Mm-hmm.
I really do. At home, however, we have a Keurig.
Okay.
A lot of you do. It's convenient. It works really well. It makes a great cup of coffee.
And then?
And then you end up like this. I have a Ziploc bag that is some of the pods.
And your heart it hurts a little when you look at this.
This is from Sunday.
Oh.
So I was, not all me, come on. I got 3 kids and a wife at home, right?
Well, some of the kids probably don't drink coffee.
No, but there are hot chocolates.
Okay.
Look at that. Hot chocolate, salted caramel.
Mm.
Right? Am I right? Like, Keurig is pretty decent. Not an advertisement for Keurig. What I want to talk to you about is what we're putting into the landfill.
Right. So the reason I have a hard time with loving Keurig is,
yeah,
look at how big that is.
That's a big hunk of plastic with some metal and other stuff.
Yeah.
Right?
That's bananas.
So quickly, cat5.tv/coffee. There's going to be a link for everything that I'm mentioning here. Yes. Everybody in the chat room is using the
Keurig. I know.
One of the things that I do love about Keurig is that you can get pods,
yes,
that are refillable and reusable and cleanable.
And those are awesome. You just put one scoop of coffee.
Yeah. Okay. So this one, which is at cat5.tv/coffee. Now, I've tried multiple. I'm showing you only the best. Okay. This one does not require a filter. This is like that reusable filter. So you just rinse it out and then let it dry and then reuse it. There's no need to buy filters for this.
Right.
So the only result of this is compost. Just the coffee grounds.
Yes.
That's it. Okay.
Rinse, reuse.
You can also put tea in it and everything else. So this is fantastic. However, I still like the convenience of the Keurig coffee pods, and I also like to be able to have variety.
Yes.
But then what do I do? Well, I don't want to sound like a bit of a dork, like, hey, well, you could be using this and saving the environment. Well,
I'm
also realistic, okay?
Caramel.
I do want salted caramel. I really, really do.
Who doesn't want salted caramel?
This is fantastic, okay? So have these. Mm-hmm. Buy these. If you use Keurig, you have to get these because they are fantastic. You just fill it up with coffee. You put it in. And I use actually espresso, and I pack it down a little bit.
Yeah.
And don't pack it down too much because then it's going to be too much pressure and it's not going to come out. But if you just pack it down a little bit, it's going to give you a pretty good cup of espresso. It's not as good as like a real cappuccino machine, but it's okay.
It's
pretty good. Yeah, and it's reusable and there's no waste, okay? So that's pretty good. But I'm realistic. I'm not going to pretend that that's all I do because I do buy these, okay? And I buy them in bulk and a lot of us do. But the pods, they build up on the counter. They're a pain in the butt to recycle. They are recyclable.
Okay.
Okay? But they're not recyclable like this. I have a cup here for a reason, a bowl here for a reason. They're not recyclable like this. You can't just throw that in the recycle bin. I'm getting coffee grounds all over.
Yeah, you have a bowl and still know you're still doing.
I'm still making a mess. You could peel the top off. It's a pain. And when you have what I showed you there, the bag from just one day's use,
yeah,
that would be a fair bit of work to try to figure out how to get that clean. So I said,
yes.
Wouldn't it be nice, Becca, my wife, if they made some kind of cutter that would allow you to easily make this.
Right.
To fix this so that it can be recycled. And then I got on Amazon and I found it. And it exists. It was my idea, but somebody else already thought of it.
Thought of it first.
And probably patented it and made it.
Okay.
So that's all it looks like. It's got little blades that pop out when you squeeze. And I'm just going to try it right here live on the air.
Okay.
Because this is good TV. So we all know how these are to recycle. They're a pain in the butt. You try to get the lid off, the top off, and it's really, really tough. So I'm just going to snap that on there. This is a used K-cup and turn. That's all there is to it. Now, presumably, I'm going to do that over top of the
green bin.
The green bin, right? But you can see.
Huh.
That took no effort whatsoever.
And then it's recyclable.
I'm making a little bit of a mess because I am, you know, just doing it. But yes, that's now, you know, give that a rinse and throw it in the recycle bin.
I just want to see the inside of this guy.
You want to see the inside? Okay. Grab another one.
It has a filter in it.
Yeah, it does.
Interesting.
Yeah. I'm going to grab another one here. This one is from a chocolate-covered cherry hot cocoa. Okay? So just simply have one of these at cat5.tv/coffee, and you're going to be able... And I know I'm just getting a couple of here because I'm trying to show the camera at the same time. You're going to do this over your compost or whatever, and it's as simple as I'm just simply turning the K-cup within the this blade apparatus, and that's it. This one, I guess the hot chocolates don't really have anything in them.
Oh, yeah, because they're not caffeinated.
Yeah, but, there's no filter or there's no coffee grounds. It was probably like an instant mix, right? But you can see how that just took the top right off. There's no effort to it. I'm just chatting away. And there we go. So this is another way that with my Keurig, I can really, really help the environment. And I do care about that a lot.
Yes.
And I want you to as well. This is something that it only costs you a couple of bucks. You're going to replace it every couple of months. It does come with two. So maybe every 3 to 6 months. And with that, you're going to be able to really, really quickly and easily recycle these. Okay.
That's smart.
And put them in the compost, like put the grounds in the compost, put the plastic in the recycle, and then you're done. As easy as that. Boom. Done. Right? Just do it. Don't even think about it. If you use Keurig, you got to do this. So that's at cat5.tv/coffee, folks. And incidentally, I'll just say that would make a really great, both of these would make a really great stocking stuffer.
For, exactly.
You know, the coffee lover on your list that probably has a Keurig device anyways.